Imagine that you went for a vacation for a month. You returned home in a happy mood. It had rained heavily in your absence, and the attic or loft where you stored your creations had a leak. Then you suddenly see that your paintings, your most cherished creations, are attacked by fungi. What will be your first reaction? Hello friends, I'm Neena Singh, a freelance artist and an art conservator, and I'll share with you how to protect your paintings from fungal attack. Remember, prevention is always better than cure. What I mean is, once the fungi infestation takes place, the remedial process is technical and has to be dealt with professional conservators. So here I will be discussing about new artworks which you have created in your lifetime. If you have inherited or acquired an expensive oil painting, then you should take the proper steps in preserving, and many of these are very easy and I am sharing those details. But it's important to note that restoration or repair should be handled strictly by a professional. Let me share my screen. What is a fungi? And remember, the fungal deterioration process can involve either a portion of the painting or all of its components may be affected. All the layers may be affected, or only the varnish layer may be affected, or only the paint layer may be affected, or it may have been penetrated much deeper, even the ground has been affected. Then it also depends that the fungal attack is from what which side, from the paint layer side or from the back of the canvas. It depends on that also. So coming to what is fungi, fungi are microscopic organisms. They have thread-like structure and multicellular. And how do you identify that whether this is a fungal growth? Wherever there is fungal growth, it is fuzzy or cotton-like in appearance. And it may be black, blue, white, green or red, any color depending upon the species. Before I proceed, a very important word of caution. Fungi, which is also known as mold, are very harmful for our health. The molds can cause stuffy nose, sore throat, coughing, burning eyes. It can also cause skin rash. And especially people who are asthmatic or who are allergic to molds, they can have severe reactions. And there are many cases where people touched fungi and with the same hand they rubbed their eyes and they lost their vision. We have to be very careful. If we see that fungi has attacked our painting, you should never touch it directly. Use hand gloves, use safety goggles before touching the painting if it has fungal attack. Under the microscope, when you see this type of structure, you will see, and depending upon, these are different types of different species of fungi. With naked eyes, you cannot identify. You need a scientific study to understand what is the nature of the fungi which has attacked. And when treatment is done, these tests are carried out that which type of fungi is there. So what type of chemical treatment should be given. So these normally we don't do at home. This is the fungal attack. This is without the microscope, the fourth bottom right corner. Here, this is a structure. This is the fungal attack on the surface, and this is without microscopic magnification. These are penicillin species, aspergillus species. These figures I have shown because they are the most commonly known fungi, and everyone is aware of what penicillium is. You know that penicillin injection and antibiotics are available. It is derived from these fungi. So it is not that always fungi are harmful, but which is harmful and which is not, you cannot identify by just looking at it. So it's better to take precautions. Now coming to the factors responsible for fungi. The two most important factors which are responsible for the growth of fungi are humidity and temperature. Now remember that there is always some molds are present in the air around us in the form of spores. They can get into a home through the open doors, windows, vents, heating system or the air conditioning system. And the molds which are present in the air outside can be brought indoors from clothing, shoes, bags, even the pets they carry with them, but they don't grow on their own. They need favorable conditions to grow. Spores are already always present. Whatsoever the environment, howsoever pure you may feel it, but spores are present in the environment. The two main conditions, favorable conditions, which are necessary for the growth of fungi are humidity and temperature. How is humidity important? What does it cause? Now, humidity leads to the dissolution of paint. It may lead to the dissolution of sizing. Then it may lead to foxing and biological growth. Biological growth means growth of fungi, growth of algae, anything. Depending upon the conditions, how you are storing the painting, on that it will depend. And most chemical reactions, this take place in the presence of certain amount of moisture which is present in the atmosphere. So, moisture which is present in the atmosphere is known as humidity. And the second condition, which accelerates the chemical reaction and even the biological reactions, it is temperature. If the temperature is very high, it may lead to desiccation. Desiccation means dryness. So, if it becomes very dry, cracking of paint layer may occur. Acceleration of chemical reaction. There's a chemical principle that for every 10 degree rise in temperature, the rate of chemical reaction doubles. Means if the temperature is 30 and it becomes 40, the chemical reaction which is responsible for biological growth may double. Any chemical reaction, it doubles for every 10 degree rise in temperature. Although molds can grow at any temperature, but the most favorable temperature is 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. It requires both the conditions, humidity and temperature, presence of moisture and appropriate temperature. There is one more factor which we have to take care of, which through our daily routine we can take care of. Presence of dust and stagnant air will accelerate the growth of fungi. So these are overall factors which are responsible for the growth of fungi, and if we avoid these, the growth of fungi can also be avoided. Why to worry about the fungi? It can cause three types of damage. The first type of damage which is important is as an artist is the aesthetic damage. The visual appearance of the painting will change. It may lead to patchy surface. So aesthetically it will not look good, and suppose we intend to sell the painting, though which art collector will buy a painting which is patchy in nature, or its aesthetic appearance has changed? No one will like that painting. The second, it may lead to mechanical damage. These fungi, they have root-like structures which may penetrate the painting layer. It may cause permanent cracks and damage. Now, fungi is a living organism. So the live fungi, all metabolic processes are taking place, and during that process, they give off acid. This acid, it leads to discoloration of the paint layer. Now, discoloration is a permanent damage. Why fungi, it attacks the oil paintings? The reason being, the canvas is organic in nature. So the presence of organic components in the paintings are the source of nutrition for fungi, and this causes damage in the works of art. The symptoms caused by the fungal deterioration are various, and they depend on the kind of object, nature of support, whether it is made up of paper, canvas or wood, or it will also depend on the kind of paint, whether you are using oil paint, watercolor. If you want to clean the painting or take care of the painting, always remember you should use a very well ventilated room. How frequently you should, if you are using your painting as a, you have hung it on the wall, so how frequently you should dust the painting? The best recommendation is twice a year. You only have to take care of few things which I'll be telling you right now. So first thing, dusting of oil paintings twice a year is good enough. While you are cleaning the painting, always make sure that the brush you are using is made up of soft bristles. These are few slides which I wanted to show it to you. See, this is a painting which has fungal growth on it. You can see these black patches. These are developed due to fungal attack. Then here you can see this lower portion, and on the right side you can see this is a white layer on the painting is due to fungus. You may also observe these type of patches in the center one. You can see these patches. Now these are very light patches and these can be treated, but if the fungal growth is very high, then treatment becomes difficult and expensive. Our paintings, we normally discard the paintings only because the expense to treat that painting will be much more than making a new painting. On the third one, you see right side, very small dot-like structures are present. This is also due to fungus growth. Left side also, you can see these are the back side of the canvas where you will this type of structure will be present. These figures I am showing you to how you can identify if this type of patches you observe on your canvas means you have to become careful now while handling these paintings. Don't allow it to grow. See, this is excessive growth of fungus on the back side. It has also damaged the stretcher. Look at the right side here, you can see on the top side you will see the stretcher has also been attacked by the fungus. These are the things which you will need: a well ventilated room, soft brush. Now look at the figure of the brush. This is the type of soft brush which you have to use for cleaning the painting. You can use a vacuum cleaner for cleaning the back side of the painting, not on the front side. Back side is clean with the help of vacuum cleaner because it absorbs all the dust and cotton swabs. Now there's a caution: you should not use feather dusters. This type of feather dusters, we think that these are very soft and we can use them, but these are not recommended because it appears to be soft, but they are not. When you have to clean the back side of the painting, first remove the painting from its frame, even from the stretcher, and put it down on an even surface, clean surface, and it should be even, preferably a table is good. And with the help of small nozzle with a brush attachment, you can vacuum the dirt slowly and carefully without applying very high pressure. But you have to be careful. Normally the paintings which I am talking about is very stable, because paintings which we are talking about, it is only say 15-30 years old, so they are quite stable. But if the paintings are old, say 100 year old painting, then you cannot vacuum clean it. Then the other precautions which you should take while cleaning of oil painting is never use water, never use any spray like choline, and all these things cannot be used for cleaning of painting. Any sort of cleaner is not recommended. Simple, you use a soft brush to clean the dust. Or you should not soak any part of the painting in water for cleaning purpose also. You should never jerk the canvas because it damages the paint layer. One more very important: now we are very environment friendly and we use lot of indoor plants in our homes, but you should avoid placing live plants around the paintings, since pests and insects that fly up from the plants and then they leave their stains on the oil painting. So then again, those stains you can remove only with the help of certain chemicals, which you cannot do it at home. Then you try to scrub it off and it eventually damages the painting. So do not scrub or roughly rub the painting to clean the surface. Now there's one more thing: keep the stretcher tight. When we buy the stretchers, they provide you with this key. Now these keys have a purpose. Due to changing season, the wood, it contracts and expands. So the canvas layer may become loose or tight depending upon the season. And these keys are used to keep the canvas stretched. So when we keep a canvas stretched, then the canvas will not touch the wall surface. So this is very important. We have to keep the canvas layer taut. Now what we can do at home to prevent the growth of fungi? The first thing is we should maintain a humidity in the range of 40 to 55%. Humidity is measured in percentage, and more than 55%, if the humidity is there, or if the humidity is very low, both the conditions are not permissible. So 40 to 45% humidity is recommended. There are certain chemicals, if we use it in the area where you are storing your paintings, that can also help you to maintain the humidity. For example, the most commonly used material which is very easily available is silica gel. You might have seen when you buy leather objects like handbags or shoes, a small packet of silica gel is present. Silica gel has a tendency to absorb atmospheric moisture, and where we store our paintings, even museum people, gallery people, they use silica gel. But at home also, we can use silica gel to control the moisture. Then another compound which is used is calcium chloride. It is also very cheaply available and it is available in the market, calcium chloride. And of course, air conditioning. If you have an air conditioner at home, maintain that. It helps to maintain the temperature as well as humidity. So that's very good. The temperature which is most recommended and suitable is 18 to 25 degrees temperature is the most suitable temperature. It protects the paintings from any type of infestation. Now, if the painting is infested by fungi, then what should be your step? The first step should be take proper protection. Howsoever small amount of fungi you see, but if you see fungal attack, never go and touch it with your bare hands. It may be very poisonous, also very harmful for your health. So remember, if you see fungal attack, use hand gloves and isolate the artwork immediately from the other pieces of art. Very important, because if one painting is contaminated, the other paintings also may get fungal attacks. So you have to isolate it. First thing should be isolation from the other artworks. Look at the stretcher. If the stretcher has been infested by the fungi, replace the stretcher immediately. If the frame is infested, replace the frame. You should not go for the treatment process and the cleaning process, because replacing the stretcher is much cheaper than treating the fungi. And one thing more I will tell you, that once the fungus leaves its stain, it may lighten, but the stain will never go away. The chemical treatment which we give, that treatment is to kill the fungi, means no further growth of fungi will take place. But if the stains are light, it may go away. It's not that. But if the stains are very dark, very deep rooted, if the fungi is, then the stains may not go. So the best thing is to protect your painting in such a way, store the painting in such a way that attack of fungi does not take place. That's the best way. Second thing that you should see, ki from where the moisture is coming, and you should eliminate that source of moisture. While storage of paintings, now as an artist, you may have hundreds of paintings which you have created, and there are so many senior artists who have been painting from last 30, 40 years, they have lots of painting to store. So when you're storing the painting, many people, what they do, they just take the whole lot of painting and put it in the loft or below the staircase, and such spaces they find out in their house to store their paintings. But what you have to do is store your paintings in a very, very dry room, because they are your precious creations. So take care of those things. Wrap it in tissue paper. Tissue paper, that is, which is, you should use tissue paper, which is acid-free tissue paper. Those acid-free tissue paper, you should wrap the painting. So it is important to store your paintings carefully. Use tissue paper. Breathable sheets should be used. You can also use foam. But you should avoid materials like bubble wrap sheets, because they trap moisture inside it. If you are storing the painting in wrapping with bubble wrap, polythene sheets, so they have, you are not maintaining vacuum inside it, so it will capture moisture inside it, and it will slowly harm the painting. So make sure that the painting has air circulation. There should not be stagnant air for a long time. Again, if there is stagnant air, it will cause fungal growth. Last one more thing, temperature. Just a reminder, 18 to 25 degrees temperature is a most appropriate temperature, and avoid high moisture. And low moisture is also not recommended, because in low moisture condition, the painting gets desiccated. It becomes dry. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this. And I hope you find this information useful. Thank you so much.